Hello everyone, Matt here. A while ago, I posted a video on 10 features you may not know MCreator has, and many of you seems to like this way of discovering new useful things about the program, so I decided to cover 10 more features you probably didn't know MCreator has. Even if you use MCreator for a very long time, there is a chance that you don't know everything, so make sure to watch the whole video, because there are some really special features in this one that you don't want to miss out on. Now let's get started. The first feature on our list is that you can cancel global events to alter vanilla functionality. For example, this can be used to make bone meal only useful in the rain, and much more. We do this by using procedures with global triggers. I'll check whether it's currently not raining in the world, and then use the cancel event to cancel it in case it's sunny. We can quickly test this out to see that we got the desired outcome. Note that not all global events are cancelable. Number 2 on our list is that you can import GIF animations inside the integrated animation maker. We open it, click Add Frames from GIF, select the GIF we want to import, and click Open. Now all our frames are in the editor and can be saved as an animated texture. Third on our list is a feature that allows you to export translations to spreadsheet format. This may not seem like a big deal, but it means that you can have external translators translate your mod using programs like Excel, and then import back the translations to add them to your mod in-game. First, we need to add the translations we want our mod to be translated to by clicking the green plus icon and selecting the desired language. To export, click the Export Current Language to CCV on the Localization tab, and to import, click the Import button next to it. Moving on to number 4. You can use the regenerate code to fix mod code generation or workspace glitches. By clicking the patch-like icon, MCreator regenerates code of all elements that haven't been logged by the user, organizes imports, refreshes workspace icons, and rebuilds the entire workspace, making it a very useful tool when encountering certain issues. Number 5 is not a feature directly related to modding, but it allows you to make your MCreator feel more special and personalized. You can change the MCreator's background image. Go to File, Preferences, UI Backgrounds, and select your preferred background. If you select multiple, a random one will be chosen each time you open another workspace. Sixth on our list is a super useful one that not many probably know about, because it's very minimalistic, yet a nice trick when trying to find a specific mod element. You can use special tags in the workspace search bar that allow you to search by categories. For example, you can use F:R to show mods that have errors in them. Writing F:locked shows all the locked elements. You can also search by the mod element type name to show all elements of that type. For example, block will list all your mod's blocks. Number 7 is all about making your life easier when importing external resources. You can drag files from your desktop or file browser to MCreator window to open a resource. You can currently import textures, sounds, Java, object, and JSON models, as well as MBT structures. Eighth on our list is a bit more technical and advanced. You can run the Minecraft's integrated profiler to find out which parts of your mod take the longest and are the most resource heavy. First, we have to run the profiler in Minecraft. We create a simple profile by typing the /debug start command and doing what we want to optimize. Afterwards, type /debug stop to save the report. We can now open the MCreator's file browser and click on the profile results file to read it. To find out what all this text means, check out the profiler getting started on the Minecraft Forges documentation. I'll link it together with the Minecraft Profiler's wiki page in the description. Don't worry if this sounded confusing to you. Like I said, this feature isn't for everyone, because it can be hard to use and isn't even relevant to simpler mods, so it's mostly for those who want to optimize their mods as much as possible and have the know-how to change a line of code or two. Moving on to number 9. Do you ever find yourself searching through tons of procedures, trying to find the one you just created to select it, but are having a hard time because the list is so long that you can't even see the scroll bar? I sure have. And here is a feature that will help you save so much time. You can search in the procedure list drop-down menu. To do that, simply click on the drop-down menu and start typing the name of your procedure. The list will filter itself in real time so that you can find it as soon as possible. Not only that, but you can use it on model lists as well, and soon you'll be able to use this feature on pretty much every drop-down menu in the program. Last on our list is support for Addons, Data Packs, and even Fabric with a third-party plugin. To create, for example, an add-on type workspace, open MCreator and click New Workspace. A workspace creation wizard opens and asks you for some settings, but before filling in the fields, we want to make sure that we select Minecraft add-on for the workspace type on the left side of the screen. If you wanted to, for example, create a data pack, we would just choose the Minecraft data pack option, or fabric in case of a fabric mod, but we'll get to that later. Now name the mod and open MCreator, and you can start working on your add-on. Note that some features are grayed out, and the fabric option isn't there by default, but we'll cover that in another video. There you go, these were 10 more features you might have not known existed in MCreator. I'd like to thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something new and useful, so let me know in the comments if any features were new to you. Because you seemed to like the first part a lot, I may be making the third part, so make sure to leave any useful tips you know in the comment section and I may include some in the next part. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notifications, like for more content like this, and comment with suggestions down below. Stay tuned!